Hey guys, this is David Kwan here to talk about my hype of Legends of Zelda, A Link Between Worlds. It's an interesting title. I don't know how I quite feel about the title, but that's the official title. Before the official title was revealed, people have been referring to this game as A Link to the Past 2, because it is that same style of game, except this is on the 3DS, it's 3D, and it has a new concept of being able to become a 2D, like if you go to any wall and you press the A button, you become like a graffiti on that wall. You can move along the wall as a 2D character. If you guys ever have seen gameplay footage or played this PlayStation Network downloadable title, Sideway New York, I guess it's kind of similar to that, except Sideway New York, that's all you are. You're just playing, you know, this 2D platforming game as a graffiti on a wall that's moving. But Link to the Past allows you to become that and then come out and it's top-down 3D world at the same time. I think this is going to have many wonderful puzzle-solving and platforming elements, and it's going to be really awesome. I'm totally excited for this game. I know many of my other videos on Nintendo games that were showcased on E3 2013, most of the time I was just like, I'm not excited for it, I don't care for it, just kind of like, whatever. But this game in particular, I don't know, I'm really excited for it. Maybe that's because my bias is that I own a 3DS, whereas I don't own a Wii U. Might have something to do with it, but just judging on, even if I did not own a 3DS, I think I would still be excited for this game in particular. It's been such a long time since a game of this type from Nintendo has ever been released. I know there were the DS Zelda games, you know, Spirit Tracks and Phantom Hourglass, but those games was more, it was really different. It was a new path for Zelda games. Many people did not like it. I have not played Spirit Tracks, but Phantom Hourglass, I actually really, really enjoyed. The stylus control, it didn't really bother me. I thought it was unique, and with the DS mechanics, there were some interesting mechanics that were there for Phantom Hourglass. But this time with Link Between Worlds is actually you're controlling the game traditionally with the analog or the D-pad, with the face buttons, and you know, using the bottom screen as inventory management and such. Looks awesome. The only concern that I have is if it feels too samey from Link to the Past, because it is a sequel, and I feel like they're gonna use a lot of this similar assets from the previous Zelda game, and like if it has the same bosses and stuff, like I would be a little disappointed. I'm hoping for as much creativity, as much innovation in this title as possible, and just with this one concept of being able to stick onto any wall and move along as a 2D graffiti character, as a sprite like that, I mean, that's exciting. I think that really changes up this entire thing. But whether Link Between Worlds would have this concept of light world and dark world, I don't know, because that would actually make, because that was a concept in Link to the Past, and that really lengthened the playtime of that game and really made it unique. It was kind of annoying and kind of got tedious. The Link to the Past, it's probably my favorite Zelda game that I've ever played. And I haven't played that many Zelda games, but it's been an amazing experience, but it was tedious. And also, Link to the Past was not an easy game, it was a really tough game. So I have to wonder like how they're going to make Link Between Worlds accessible, how hard it's going to be. I wouldn't be too worried if it was too easy. I would still be okay with that. If it's too hard, I would be okay with that too. I think either way, I'm excited. This game could be really awesome stuff for the 3DS. Like I said, my biggest concern is that it doesn't become like something that to take advantages of our nostalgia too much. Because some games are guilty of that. Sonic 4, for example, way too guilty. It's just like, oh, you guys miss the 2D Sonic platforming games. Well, here's this new game in 3D graphics, but oh my gosh, it was just too much, too unoriginal. So I'm really worried about that. I wish that Link Between Worlds is as original, as creative, and as innovative as possible. But it's one Nintendo game I'm really excited for. What do you guys think? Share me your comments and your thoughts in the comment section below. Yeah, thanks for watching. Cheers.